to those extraordinary scenes that we saw in those photographs. What a moment there must have been. But first, I want to bring us up to speed with the news of the photographs of a dead Osama bin Laden. What is the current situation with regard to those?
Well, I think as we've indicated during the course of the last several days, we're making some consideration of the potential ramifications of the release of any such photos. I think it's important to put it in the context of all the information that has been put out in the last 36 hours or so, to include a DNA analysis, a facial recognition analysis, a lot of the intelligence that has gone into and come out of the raid that night. And then, of course, to keep in mind that does not seem to be any credible refutation of the basic fact that Osama bin Laden is dead. Nevertheless, we have taken a look at the potential ramifications of this, of inserting new images, which we know will be misused and propagandized by our enemies, and trying to make some decisions about the ramifications of that for the safety of our troops and our allies' troops, the safety of our diplomats and our intelligence professionals, and the safety of private Americans who are overseas, and including private citizens of our allied countries. So we'll make those decisions based on the assessments that we're getting, and we'll do that in the next several days.
I mean, all that is perfectly understandable, but clearly there's another side to this coin, which is that there are already elements within the Islamic world beginning to question the veracity of Osama bin Laden's death. And clearly the best way to establish that he is dead is to release one of these photographs.
Oh, I don't know that that's the best way to establish it, Pierce. I think there's probably a number of different ways, and that's why we've made the kind of information available that we've made available in the last 36 hours. So I don't know that you've seen it. I maybe you have. I haven't really seen anything credible that's doubting the fact that Osama bin Laden is dead. And so, again, we'll consider the context and we'll consider the ramifications and make that decision. But I do think it's important to keep in mind the brilliance of this operation as a result of the gutsy decision the president made. But the brilliance also comes from the bravery of those operators that did this, and also the case that the intelligence professionals put together over the course, painstakingly put together over the course of several years, where the president's very proud of and gratified by that great work.
I mean, one final question with regard to the pictures. Have you actually seen them yourself?
I've seen some pictures, yes.
And what do they depict?
Oh, I'm not going to get into trying to describe them. I think it leaves no doubt the basic fact that Osama bin Laden is dead.
Moving to the extraordinary photographs that came out yesterday from what happened on Sunday, you were there right in the middle of this, next to Hillary Clinton, next to Barack Obama. In the end, you're human beings witnessing this extraordinary event unfurling. Were you able to actually see any video footage from the scene as it happened?
No, we weren't able to see video footage from the scene. We were following, getting real-time updates in a variety of media. But such video footage was not available. I do think it was quite remarkable that the president maintained his steely demeanor throughout this, notwithstanding, as John Brennan depicted yesterday, the anxious moments that I think occupied many of us during those during that time. But I also think that what's important in my mind about that picture is I think it's emblematic of the kind of teamwork that went into the generation of the options for the president around this operation. I think that's also emblematic of the president's leadership and the leadership of Tom Donilon, who ran a very steadying process throughout this to try to tee up the options for decision to the president.
But tell me, when you're in that kind of situation, I mean, it must be incredibly tense. Describe for me, paint a picture of what it was like.